Delhi. Rahul.
Yes, sir.
Seema.
Yes, sir.
Kajal.
In a very faint voice.
Yes, sir.
Kajal, are you okay?
Yes, sir, I'm fine.
What is that in your hand? Good morning, fellow Toastmasters.
Good morning.
Toastmaster of the day and aspiring Toastmasters.
Good morning.
Who's Kajal? What was this incident about? Before I come to that, let me take you on a flashback. 2008, I left the army on VRS, or what we call premature retirement, after doing 21 years in the army. And I plunged into the field of training and development, because that's what I wanted to do. So me and my sister, we teamed up, we were in Delhi, set up an institute called Transition. We wanted to help the students to transition into confident, communicative, cooperative, and contributive citizens of India. We set off with a very, very positive note, worked out our programs, and every day in the morning we used to sit in a car, zoom into some area of Delhi or NCR and pick up some 5-6 colleges, walk into the director's or principal's office, cold calling, that's what you call, and present our programs with lovely brochures and nice visiting cards, you know, that initial rush of being that entrepreneurship, everything going well. And the principals would give us, say, great program, we'll come back to you. Have you heard that line?
Yes.
We'll get back to you. So this continued, this investment in marketing for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. We touched nearly 70 to 80 institutions in that entire area. But all we were hearing was, we will get back to you. Nobody was getting back to us. So that all that initial euphoria and optimism turned into pessimism, disappointment, and despondency, and despair. And people started wondering, is this really going to work? One day, I got a message in the morning. You get this good morning, beautiful messages. It was quite interesting. It said, you love what you do so much that you are willing to do it free of cost. And people like your work so much that they're willing to pay anything for it. And I kept wondering that do these quotes really apply in real life, or it's just something which passes off like a cloud in the sky? So I actually decided that let me test this quotation. That do quotes actually work? All these laws of attraction and so many things you would have heard. So there was a school in our locality, an NGO school. I walked into that school one fine day with all our brochures and cards, and I went to the principal's office and I said, look, I'm so and so, and this is the kind of programs we do, and I want to do a program for your students completely free of cost. I don't want to charge anything. As per the quotation, she looked at me, kept looking at me. I thought I said something wrong. And then she broke into a big smile and she said, you are godsend. I said, really? She said, we've been looking for a trainer for our 12th class students, our first batch, which is just about to pass out in a few months' time. And being from the lower income group, all of them, along with their graduation, would be working in some place or the other as part-time. And we contacted so many trainers and all of them were quoting very, very high rates, and which we cannot afford. And right when the time I had given up on this project, you just walk into my office and you are giving us a program which you actually need, and you're giving it free of cost. So I said, absolutely. So when do I start? Monday. So next Monday, me and Mr. we walked into a class with about 15 exuberant students and started our work, and it was a 1 month program. It was going on beautifully, great interaction, getting good feedback from both the students, teachers, and the principal. But a lot of time when you do these kind of programs, you're really not sure as to is it really working well and connecting? But one day that changed. That was the day. Kajal.
Yes, sir.
What is that in your hand? Sir, I'm okay. Okay, meet me after the class. So next day when, at the end of the class, I called her. I saw she had a bandage on her hand and with a needle sticking out, the one which they have for that IVR, the drip. Sir, what has happened to you? Sir, I was admitted in a hospital for dehydration and I've taken leave from there to come and attend your class. I said, why should I have stayed there? You could have attended it later on. She says, sir, these classes are very, very precious to me. I'm learning so much. I would rather stay a day extra in the hospital than miss this class. That was the day I felt that, okay, things are really going well. And we finished the program, great feedback, and that program led us to a number of other programs because the director of the school, one of the directors of the school was an ex-IAS officer. She introduced us to many other schools in Delhi, government of Delhi programs, and it just went on in the next 8 years. After that program, we did programs for about 25,000 students. One thing led to another. It just kept going. Few years back, I got to know that Rahul had joined KFC, Seema had become a teacher in that very same school, and Kajal, who's one of the brightest students, she wanted to do a CA. She got a financial loan from that school itself. She did her CA, and 2 years back, I got a LinkedIn request, connection request from Kajal, and when I opened that, say, sir, I have completed my CA. I am now a chartered accountant. So what I have experienced in this entire journey is do what you love and love what you do, and whatever you give to the world will come back to you. Thank you.